Brandon, you know.
Nick and Trudy White escaped the rat race in favour of the good life in the Nottinghamshire countryside. They joined an environmental housing project and moved into a new, non-polluting, self-sufficient house, which even had its own organic garden. Now they want to decorate the inside of the house to the same eco standards. So I joined Anne McKevitt to see if it could be done. The new house was designed to make the most of natural light and solar power. Each house has a huge conservatory at the front, with the other rooms behind. Nick and Trudy and their two children, Rebecca and Francesca, moved from a temporary caravan to their new home in February. But when I arrived on a rainy day in May, the house still looked as though it needed a lot of work. So how on earth did you come to be here? And you thought it looks rather like a building site to me still.
We actually saw it in a small ad, and they were looking for a fifth family to join an eco project, and it described the lake, the way of living, and it just sounded perfect.
Come on in.
Do you want to just take your boots off, Tessa?
I'm sorry
about this. It's so muddy. We're trying to keep the rest of the house clear of mud.
Well, even Tyler's already got here, can't you look?
Oh, yeah.
The living room was totally unfinished, with bare walls and pale floor tiles. Anne really had her work cut out for her.
Is it going to be tricky because there's two empty spaces over there?
It is actually the room from hell, Tessa. I've been sent on the hardest mission yet because they've got this long, narrow room. It's really high up at this end, low at that end, and we've got two whacking big pipes going through the middle. And it's got to look great, so it's going to take a lot of work.
So how green do you want this room to be?
Well, it's quite important to us that all the products and materials that we use in the room are as eco-friendly as possible. Having said that, we don't want it to look like a sort of hippie commune. We want it to look stylish and comfortable.
I do think it'd be quite a good idea to actually define the two spaces as one living area here, and then that as a kind of more cosy area at the bottom. And somehow doing a slight division down there, so there is a kind of very definite division between the two. Mm. And also it needs some kind of optical illusion with a paint effect or colour or something to make the room feel slightly wider.
Anne wanted to balance light by building screens which would stand in front of the French windows. And on the opposite wall, she would use a board covered in aluminium leaf to reflect the light. Also, at the back end of the room, she planned a cosy TV pit full of cushions for the children. And all of this was to be done with the maximum use of eco-friendly materials. So it was off to the DIY stores. If you want to save the rainforest, look out for the FSC label. That's the Forest Stewardship Council, who check that wood has been taken from a managed forest. Anne also found some paint with a low VOC content, which means it's a lot less toxic. But we found that it needed more coats than the average paint. The sofa went off to be reupholstered, and our carpenter set to work on the cutouts for some new doors, which Anne designed to close off the corridor from the living room. The ugly pipes were boxed in, and a low seat wall was built to separate the TV pit area from the rest of the room.
What about light bulbs? How are you getting on investigating those?
This is very similar to a standard light bulb that people use, but is a low-energy light bulb. And this particular one uses 80% less electricity than a normal light bulb for the same amount of light given off.
Our decorator, briefed by Anne, marked off wide horizontal stripes to create the illusion of width, and using masking tape, painted on the lighter colour. Once that colour was dry, the masking tape was pulled off and repositioned before applying the darker colour. Perfect stripes. To finish the doors, Anne, ever eco-conscious, bought reclaimed glass and used a specialist paint to create a stained glass effect. More recycling, as she found a beautiful bowl made from an old washing machine door, and commissioned a one-off coffee table built out of board made from recycled plastic coat hangers and coffee cups.
Looking brilliant, I think it looks great.
How difficult was it to get it all together? It wasn't too bad, but the worst thing was doing those cushion pads. We could have bought feather-filled cushion pads, but Rebecca was allergic to them, so we actually had to make all those cushion pads ourselves and fill them with coir filling.
Coir is coconut husk, which is a totally renewable waste product.
How did you get on with the sofas?
The sofa was great, because we actually got linen and upholstered the whole thing. The linen was 100% linen, untreated, so there's no chemicals near it. And the fabric was about £200, but the total cost in the sofa was about £600 with all the actual upholstery work.
That's the price of a new sofa.
It is, but this is all about recycling. So what we've done is we've taken a very, very good piece of furniture and we've chosen any fabric we wanted and covered it, and it looks really nice when it's finished. Well, with lighting, what I do is I use those great eco-friendly light bulbs, which doesn't waste any energy, but place them inside these fantastic light fittings which we've dotted around the room. I've also reduced the number of lighting points so that there aren't so many lights being used anyway. And do you remember how dark this area was down here? Well, I've used the natural reflection of the daylight so that you're getting the maximum effect with this aluminium leaf board reflecting it all back into the room, almost like a mirror.
As Anne set off to face another home front challenge, everyone settled down to enjoy their new room. The children certainly seemed to like their end of the room. But what did Nick and Trudy think?
We haven't had to compromise along the way on our green principles, and yet we've got an amazing room at the end of it.
It's really interesting at night and early in the morning, you get quite weird sort of lighting effects from this room, so that when you approach it from other parts of the house, you get this warm glow, and it really has changed the whole atmosphere of this part of the house.
Salvage is all around us, and particularly so in the case of Neville Griffiths, whose cottage is literally in the midst of it all in his own salvage yard.
I'm fine, so you've come to help me renovate my cottage.
Well, what needs renovating? It all looks kind of original and nice to me.
Well, this is the illusion. It's made out of salvage. Old architraving, floorboards, quarry tiles. What you're here for is the original part of the house, so in you go. This is the salvage dining room, soon to be.
Yeah, well, this looks like it needs attention.
The focal point of the room, we'll make a simple fire surround, and now we've got a bit of space, a nice fire basket. And something for the centre of the room. But you've just walked past the materials, so let's go back out and go through them.
So everything out there is going
yep.
to come in here. Well, what about a nice big bit like this? Oh, a bit heavy.
If it was a sort of...
We sorted through some wood Neville had in his yard, looking for old floorboards to make up a basic frame, as well as pieces with interesting detail for the facade. We tried out a few designs to see which one worked best. We felt that something simple would work well in this room.
Now that's the one I think I like. That looks really good.
We measured the chimney breast, then set to work cutting the wood to size.
Look at that. Beautiful timber. You can smell it.
We cleaned up the wood, then used brackets at the back to attach the sections together.
There, brilliant.
Very simple.
Isn't it? So look here, this is this board that we've been having a go at, Neville. We've got some of the paint off, but it's still not looking the same colour as this board down here. What are we going to do about it?
Well, we could either run an old tea bag along it to darken this down, or we could scrub it all over with some ordinary household bleach, and that'll make it a more of a uniform colour. This is a fantastic material, real earthy qualities, and with a bit of cleaning up and the right design, this will look gorgeous. We are going to make the salvage dining table.
We cut the tiles to size using a hard tile cutting machine, then cut the corners off a piece of 1-inch plywood. We fitted screws which would attach to the legs. It's important to do this before you begin tiling. Start tiling from the centre of the table and work your way out. We use coloured grout to match the slate. Then went in search of legs for the table.
So will these work, Neville?
Well, we could use lots of materials, but if we follow the rooftop theme, we could use these old downpipes and hoppers. With the slates, fantastic.
If you're going to use old drain pipes covered in lead paint, make sure you get them professionally cleaned. We attached the legs to the table with wooden pegs. A lick of polish and a coat of varnish later, the tabletop was ready.
I think it's a very beautiful table, but it has taken us ages to do it, hasn't it?
But it's been fun doing it, and you end up with something totally unique. Well, Tessa, we've made the fast round and we've got the table. For the final touch to the room, a bit of metamorphosis.
So what on earth are you going to be doing with this then, Neville?
These leftover bits of railings will make a great fire basket. And this is going to be the simplest thing to do.
Neville cut the railings into sections using tools hired from a local company. He then drilled screw holes in the sides and ends of the bars.
We'll start at the front first, because we don't want any holes showing. So there it is, away you go. Then what we'll do is pull the round bars across and work backwards. No welding, just you and a screwdriver.
Make up the front section first, then attach the sides and back, leaving the base till last.
Well, I have to say, this is really coming together now, and it's quite good.
The thing to remember is it's not just about saving money, it's about saving energy. It's reusing materials. There's a little thing that I will think of, it's have you forgotten your three R's? Reclaim, reuse and reinvent.
Oh, God, it's heavy.
I know. So it's made out of real materials.
Done.
It's just a way of looking at things. There's potential in everything. You just have to release it.
Roof slates can be picked up from as little as a pound each. Floorboards come at £4 a foot. And metal and wood cutting tools for all these jobs can be hired from £13 a day.